Hello friends, this is Manav from Civil Center and I welcome all of you back to our channel.
So friends, in today's video, we'll find out how to apply wind loads to a model in Tekla Structural Designer. So as you can see here, this is a G+3 building model and we have taken wind panel from the option model and we'll apply wind panels to all the walls surrounding the building. The reason behind it, because it is a frame structure and we have to consider the building as a closed one because it will be surrounded by panels, say of say masonry works or glass panels. So as the wind load is a lateral load, so we need to provide panels in the software so that we can take into account the effect of the lateral wind load properly. So as you can see, this is a very easy process. You just have to select the wall panels and click on three corners. In the fourth corner, you have to double click, and until it is green, it's good, and if it's red, then it's an error, and we'll apply the wind loads over the plinth level. Now these two portions are remaining, so let us see what happens if we apply wind panels here, because it is a curved portion, and by the same process I am applying the wind load here, and we'll also just check by putting panels here also. So after that we can now move forward to the model and check if there is any error. So when you validate, we have been showing an error. Now let us check the error. The panel is surrounded by, okay, this error is coming. So minimize this error. We have to find out a way. So this is a common error which comes in the panels. To mitigate that, what you have to do is that let us delete the panels first, and then we'll go to the properties of the panels. Let us go to the properties option. We have taken wind panel, the properties option, and we'll take a wall panel again. Okay, these two portions we'll just provide again, and this time let us provide this. There, one panel has been provided, and the second panel we'll provide this also. And then we'll just escape and then select this, and then we'll change the angle by 90 degree. So it is 0 degree first, we'll change the angle to 90 degree. Okay, now let us validate the model. So the model has been validated. So friends, this is a way which in which you can minimize the error, or you can cancel the error in while applying, you know, wall panels during wind load. So this is the process of application of wind panels, and now for applying the wind load, we'll go to our loading wind wizard. We'll select the worst case data, and now here you can give the directions and everything. So to consider all the data, they take automatically, but you have to give the basic wind speed. We've given basic wind speed of 55, which is the basic wind speed in Bhubaneswar, and we can also ignore the wind below the plinth level. So we'll select next. Now if your terrain, if your building is located in adjacent to some buildings, you can select this option, and fetch distance we can take as 5 by default, and here we don't need to do anything. You can just click on next and then we can finish it. So as we had told you, we had applied the wind load, and now again we'll go to the wind wizard, and then as I had told, we'll just again change the orientation to 0, and for this we are doing for only checking purposes, and we'll just select building type and basic wind speed again, and this also we'll enter again. Just redoing the steps so that you can grasp it properly, and then we can just click on finish. So this is our wind wizard process, and then after the wind wizard, then we have wind load cases. We can click this and we'll add 4 load cases. So as we have told you, the wind is a lateral load, so it can act in 4 directions, that is 0, 90, 270 and 180. So sorry, 0, 90, 180 and 270. So these are the angles in which the wind will act laterally along this direction and this direction. So we've added that. So the wind load has successfully been applied. After that, we'll move to the seismic wizard, and then we'll apply the seismic loads. So we can ignore a seismic below the plinth level, which is our base in this case, So we can ignore seismic forces below that. Type of soil will consider as medium soil. So we're moving forward, and all other data they can take automatically, which is the beauty of the software. They take most of the data automatically. We are considering frame structure, so we are selecting this RC moment resisting frames, masonry fills, and then we'll just click on next. Here also we'll select a moment frame systems, and all of the data they will take by default. So as you can see, this is a very easy process for applying the wind load and then the seismic load, and then you need to generate some combinations due to the seismic load. We'll just select this. Here we'll unselect all the working stress type load combinations so that we don't need that. So after that we'll just click on next and then finish. So we're done here. I will generate some load combinations. We'll click on generate, and then we'll just take operating, and then same thing we'll need to do. We need to unselect the working stress types, and after that we'll be good to go. After that we can click on next. We're done here. So these are the load combinations I generated. Now let us analyze the building. We'll do a static analysis here, and after that we'll go for the design of the building. So after the design, you can see that which members pass and which members fail upon the application of the load. So this is a small clip from our project of a G+3 building. It is a consultancy work, and telling you, we provide training on the software Tekla Structural Designer, and when we provide the training, we teach you the practical concepts, and we teach you from the starting to the end how to generate the final drawings which we provide to the client. So to join our training, you can contact the number which will be given in the description of this video, and also you can mail us at team@civilcenter.in, civilcenter.in. So this is our model. As you can see, some members have passed, some members have failed, but the model and the process of application of loads has been completed. So see you in the next video. Bye bye.